Hello, my name is Rahul Ramesh Thawai. In this lecture, we are going to see the dynamic analysis. So first, we are going to deal with the free axial vibration of the rod. So governing differential equation for the free axial vibration of the rod is given by AE dou square u by dou x square is equal to rho a dou square u by dou t square. So I will call this as equation number 1. Here I will separate the two variables x and t. So I will write down one function u, that is a function of x and t. It is given by a u, which is a function of x, into e raised to power minus I omega t, which is a function of t. So I will calculate dou u by dou x, that is equal to, I will differentiate u because that is a function of x, that is du by dx, into e raised to power minus I omega t as it is. Now I will calculate dou square u by dou x square. Again I will differentiate du by dx because it is a function of x. So I will get d square u by dx square into again e raised to power minus I omega t as it is. So I will call it as equation number 2. Next I will calculate dou u by dou t. Now u is a function of x, so it will remain constant, into derivative of e raised to power minus I omega t, that is minus I omega into e raised to power minus I omega t. Next I will calculate dou square u by dou t square, that is again u is a function of x, so it will remain constant, so it is u into derivative of minus I omega into e raised to power minus I omega t is minus I omega square into e raised to power minus I omega t. So I will get u into I square omega square e raised to power minus I omega t. So I will get its value as minus u omega square e raised to power minus I omega t. So I will call this as equation number 3. Now I will put these values from equation number 2 and 3 into equation number 1. So I will get AE d square u by dx square into e raised to power minus I omega t is equal to rho a into minus u omega square e raised to power minus I omega t. So AE d square u by dx square plus rho a omega square into u is equal to 0. So if I solve this equation by using Rayleigh-Ritz method mapped over general element, I will get a solution like this. AE by L into inside a matrix 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 into u1 u2 minus rho a omega square L by 6 into inside a matrix 2 1 1 2 into u1 u2 is equal to f1 f2. So I will rewrite in a generalized form it as stiffness matrix K, that is AE by L 1 minus 1 minus 1 1 into displacement u, that is u1 u2 minus omega square into matrix M, that is rho A L by 6 is equal to force, that is F. Now here I will calculate the consistent mass matrix. Basic formula for mass is density into volume. So I will multiply density by a small volume and integrate for a total volume. So formula for mass, it is given by integration rho into n transpose into n, that is given by 1 only, into dv, and that dv I will integrate for 0 to v. So it is equal to, now I replace that volume by area into thickness. So I will, instead of dv, I will put it as a into dx, and I will integrate that dx for the length 0 to l. So my formula becomes integration rho as it is into that dv I will replace by a into dx, and I will integrate it for 0 to l into n transpose into n. So for a bar element, this matrix n, it is basically known as shape function matrix. So for linear bar element, there are two shape functions, that is n1 and n2, where n1 is given by 1 minus x bar by l and n2 is given by x bar by l. Now I will put this value in the formula of mass matrix M. So mass matrix M is given by rho into A, it is constant, so I will take it out of the integration. Integration 0 to L into transpose of shape function matrix, it is 1 minus x bar by L E. x bar by le into shape function matrix n, it is 1 minus x bar by le x bar by le into dx. So rho is equal to integration 0 to l. Now I will multiply by first row first column, that is 1 minus x bar by l square. Next first row second column, that is x bar by l into 1 minus x bar by l. Next I will go for second row first column, that is x bar by l into 1 minus x bar by l. Next second row second column, that is x bar by l the whole bracket square, so is equal to rho into a integration 0 to l into inside a matrix. I will split every term. So if I split the first term, that is 1 minus 2 x bar by l plus x bar square by l square. Next second term, x bar by l minus x bar square by l square. Next third term, x bar by l minus x bar square by l square. Next fourth term, x bar square by l square
into dx,
so is equal to rho into a. Now I will integrate it. So I will get it x bar minus 2 by l into x bar square by 2 plus 1 by l square into x bar cube by 3. Next term I will get it as 1 by l into x square by 2 minus 1 by l square into x cube by 3. Next third term I will get it as 1 by l into x bar square by 2 minus 1 by l square into x bar cube by 3. Fourth term, which I will get it as 1 by l square into x bar cube by 3, so is equal to rho a. Now I will put the limits, that is 0 to l. So I will get l minus l plus l by 3. Next term l by 2 minus l by 3. Next term l by 2 minus l by 3. Next term l by 3
is equal to rho a.
L by 3, l by 6, l by 6, l by 3.
So I will take l by 6 common, that is rho a l by 6, 2, 1, 1, 2. So consistent mass matrix is given by rho a l by 6 into inside a matrix 2, 1, 1, 2.
Now we will see the lump mass matrices. In lump mass matrices, it is assumed that the total mass of the element, it is distributed equally at every node. So if the total mass of the element is rho a l, then rho a l by 2 will go to node 1 and rho a l by 2 will go to node 2. So if I need to write down a lump mass matrices, that is matrix M, so it is given by rho a l by 2 0 0 rho a l by 2. So I can get rho a l by 2 as a common term. So it is given by rho a l by 2 into inside a matrix 1 0 0 1. Thank you for watching the video. In the next lecture, we will be solving the problems based on dynamic analysis of free axial vibration of the rod.